Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Artichoke Music. I did say in my little write-up for tonight's event, what a long, strange trip it's been. It's been well over a year. We shut down on March 11th. Welcome back. How many of y'all have been to Artichoke before? Yes. How many have been to this location before? Yes. This is great. I'm glad to have you back. I'm really excited about tonight's show. And we've got some great performers. And I'll talk about the first performer. And y'all may have been expecting Tom Arnold, but unfortunately, Tom had a serious fall 2 days ago and broke his shoulder, his left shoulder, and is out for a while. Well, so let's keep Tom in our thoughts. We want him back. He had a great show planned. He does have a new album out. Please go to his website. It's wonderful. TomArnold.com. It's all been redone. He's very proud of the website, and you can find all his music there, and that's a great place to start to keep up and give him some support while he is in recovery. I am pleased that when I talk to our team about what we might do, our wonderful producer, Gary Furlow, is joining the show tonight and is going to open the show. Let's give Gary a great hand. Not only does he do sound, but he is a wonderful musician. He has played guitar all his life. He is from the heart of Americana music in the United States and New Orleans. A lot of people, places started there, and he lives and breathes folk music. So I'd like you all to welcome Gary Furlow tonight at our first Friday Night Coffeehouse. Thank you so much.
Kind of started with two songs that I wrote recently about unrequited love. If I had a wheel, I could roll all day, cross fields and bridges without a care. And in no time, you'd find me there if I had a wheel. If I had a wheel, I had a plow. I'd cut furrows so straight, split fallow. We'd work for you till late if I had a plow, if I had a plow. Oh, the windmill turns and the water will churn, and in the good times laughs on down the slough. But when the summer rains won't come and the streams grow dry, seems the parcher longs for me and you. If I had your love, surely calm me down, would make me feel that I'm okay. And each heartbeat was worthy of the sound. If I had your love, if I had your love. And if I had your love, then I would be a better man than I have to be. I'd cross fields and furrows, hills and streams, instead of haunting corners without you. If I could make you happy, I'd be light as a feather. I'd settle down, no longer ride the wind. And we could hold each other against the storms together. If I had a wheel, if I had a wheel.
Well, that's kind of the prairie folky version. This is the New Orleans version. Man, I've been cheated on, lied to. Seems every day I've been alive. Rattled to my bones. I know that I've been jived. Well, if I wanna get ahead, gotta leave that girl behind. This green door slammed behind me, gonna free my troubled mind. Seem to be losing some of my joyfulness. Gotta get me out of town. Tracks down to the end of the line. I know she'll only bring me down. She'll only make me moan. There's company in conversation when I'm all alone. Slip away at the crossroads and get me out of town. Well, now the sun is beating down. My eyes can feel the heat. Shoe leather so worn thin, my toes can feel that gritty street. Some say that love's a fire you never got a stoke. Man, I say love's a punchline to a never-ending joke. Well, you might think that I'm a dangerous man. Some call me a loner, neither beggar man nor thief, just a poor boy on the road now, walking highway 90 from the chef down to the pearl. Is that high tide river make me out of this world? Purge such thoughts out of my mind and get me out of town. Oh, I'm so weary of this walking. I'm so motivated. These blues that I'm feeling, well, they're just so overrated. Go north or east or west. Choice I gotta choose. Got me going south, cause that's way back. Well, now that picket fence is picking, gate hinge is broken down. That oak tree is a sagging's man, his Mars is on the ground. Don't wanna fix on what's broken, it'll only make me mean. I certainly could use a drink, but that won't help me. Just one thing I gotta do. Get me out of town. Just keep my boots pointed that way. And get me out of town.
Thank you. Thank you. We're missing Tom tonight, and just to let him know we're thinking about it. May I have a shot, please? We arranged this earlier. Tom, as you may know, is part of the Whiskey Poets. And so I figured it's a good time to, I hope he's watching. We're gonna raise our glasses. Thank you, my dear. Thank you so much. Raise our glasses to Tom Arnold, swift recovery, music to come. Thank you. Oh, yeah. Thank you. As Bob said, I was born and raised down in New Orleans. And this time of year, we get what we call thunderstorms. Not just little things, not just rain. Like when you get here up here, you get occasional thunderstorms. You get a couple of pieces of lightning. It gets dark for a moment. It's done. Down there, it's a way of life. We have thunderstorms that people name. And this time of year, the weather down south is pretty, unless there's a hurricane coming in, it's pretty predictable. Be clear as a bell in the morning. About noon, it'll cloud over enough to start raining around 2-3:30. Rain pretty good from 2 to 4. 4 o'clock, it blows itself out. And then it stops and it clears off for the evening. Humidity is 120%, but, you know, But every once in a while, we get a line of thunderstorms coming through, and the clouds turn gray-green, and you can hear this low rumble way off in the distance. You feel it almost more than you hear it. And we used to go sit on our screen porch and watch those little suckers roll in off the lake. Hey, mama, come over here. You sip your wine, I got my beer. While the skeeters and the flies tap on the screen door. Hey, mama, ease on back. What you doing? Just relax. I ain't had no shoes on since the 1st of May. Except when we stroll down to church. One of the things we do here at Artichoke is we teach people how to play and how to sing and also how to write. We have several classes on songwriting, and this song was written actually at the old place where when we had a parking lot, because we had songwriting classes on Tuesday night. And so about 50 to 55% of the songs were written in that parking lot on Tuesday night. Including this one. And it's a song about songwriting, I think, about songwriting. Loved ones are strange, like strangers with lovers tonight. In a blue-collar city, hearts are scattered across the land. Oh, I know all your faults, and you've learned all about my addiction. Still we let the truth fade and wither away in the night. I remember those flaming wildflowers on old dusty roadsides.
sky of deeper blue. Oh, the hills, they rolled on, and our hands just needed each other. Touring down to the warm, salty waters, the bay and the sea. Are we captain or tiller or sail, or the wind that is blowing? And we feel things are tugging, but which way it's pulling is key. Headed out for Jerusalem's walls, together not knowing. Is it rhyme? Is it rhythm? Is it us? Is it you?
Another one of the new songs, just one of our exercises in the songwriting. I took a couple of songwriting classes while we were in on hiatus, if you will. And of course, it was all online and everything. So it was, you know, they give you, what is it, 3 words out of a hat, and you got to write a song about it. So I don't remember what the words were, but they're somewhere in this song. You say you love me, always be true, but people talk, and I got my eye on you. I've been around this block more than a few times, looks like I'm coming round again. Oh, they say there's this old boyfriend that you've been talking to. Old memories are tragic, I got my eye on you. I've been around this block more than a few times. Looks like I'm coming round again. They say I fall in love too easy, and I always give it everything I got. But you took my heart and you headed for the door, and I can make you stop. What can I do now? My youth and love is spent, and these wide eyes hopes are overloaded, my passion spent.
around this block more than a few times. Looks like I'm coming round again. They say I fall in love too easy, and I always give it everything I got. But you took my heart and you headed for that door, and I can make you stop. Oh, went out for a stroll, think it over, weigh my options and future plans. 'Cause I've been around this block more than a few times. Looks like I'm coming round again. I've been around this block more than a few times. Looks like I'm coming round again.
Thank you. One of the pleasures of my life right now is I have a 12-year-old and a 10-year-old granddaughter, two granddaughters that live in Chicago. So I only get to see them three times a year. Actually saw them about a month and a half ago. I took my brand new car, and after I got my vaccinations all cool and I was waited 2 weeks and all like that, I got in my car and I drove 6,000 miles. Well, 3,000 to New Orleans, saw my family, my son, my sisters and brothers and all that. Then drove New Orleans to St. Louis to Chicago and saw my grandkids. And then drove back along the northern tier and went to Devil's Tower and then went to Yellowstone again for the next time and did and went to the Tetons. Just had a wonderful time driving and all like that. But the big highlight, of course, was seeing my grandkids. And they are just incredible girls. They are ice skaters. They're both terrific ice skaters. And the youngest is a great artist. She has a thing called Lola Creates. There's two of them. One of them's named Cleo Nola. N-O-L-A is her middle name for New Orleans, Louisiana, which is where her mom was born. And the other one is called Lola Bean Beswick, and daddy's from Boston. So that's where that came from. But I only get to see them a couple, three times a year just because of the distance. Hopefully they'll be coming out in August. That's still being set up. But anyway, I wanted them to know I was always thinking about them. So I wrote this song. I was your shadow, we could play tag in the sun. I'd chase you around and hold on tight, and I'd keep your secrets, everyone. If I was your shadow, cobblestones would be a thrill. And I'd fly across the canyon at sunset if you stood high. Your shadow, I'd stretch out when the sun warms your back, or race ahead at streetlights, and you passed under in the night. If I was your shadow, I'd climb up walls to bend and grow, and we'd snuggle close side by side in your nightlight's gentle glow. Oh, and I would hide on cloudy days and wash away in raindrops and laugh when the lightnings flash away. Oh, and I can ride a two-wheeler too, and I can skip rope just as fast as you. I'd be amazing till the twilight ends the day. If I was your shadow, I'd dress up just like you, and you'd hide and I'd always seek you out. Bet I'd always find you too, and we'd look good in hats, this snappier the better. I can be taller and I can be shorter, and we look cool in your blue sweater. But Grandpa's 2,000 miles away, let's go out and play. I'm here every day, you see, 'cause your shadow, well, that's me. Thank you all very much. It's been a pleasure. Tom, be well. Get better.
Thank you, Gary. Gary's been a rock this whole time. We produce shows together, and everything that you see here, the ability to produce video for across the country, is thanks to Gary Furlow. Let's give him a big hand. Well, it is my honor to welcome Steve Cheseborough, one of my favorite blues guitarists, a teacher here at Artichoke, and a student of Mississippi Delta blues. He wrote the book on where to find the holy sites of the Mississippi Delta blues, and you can find that book in the back at the merch table as well. But Steve is a wonderful guitarist. He's a wonderful harmonica player. He has been teaching here at Artichoke for almost 4 years. And when he teaches, he's teaching in the style of. So he'll teach a class on the works of Robert Johnson or the works of Muddy Waters or the works of Bo Carter. And so let's welcome Steve Cheseborough tonight. For a Thank wonderful you. Set.
Thank you. All right. So great to be here. Just to be playing anywhere is exciting these days, especially at a wonderful place like Artichoke. Love this place, or not only the place. I mean, it's as we proved, it's Artichoke still exists when this building is closed. We've still had Artichoke as an entity for this past year and a half. But it's good to get back in this room too. Let's try one by Bo Carter, who Bob just mentioned, one of the great blues artists of the 1930s. You to know, sweetie pie, I want you to know. Well, that Lily been doing to me, girl, don't you do it no more. Girl, I want you to know, baby doll, I want you to know. Well, that Lily been screwing with me. Girl, don't you screw it no more. Well, I'm a stranger here, just walked in your town. Well, ain't none of these mamas gonna turn me down. They saying, baby, they saying, honey. I want you to understand. Baby, try and understand. I don't mean you no more good. You better get yourself another man. Oh, yeah. want you to know. Says, baby, doll, I want you to know. Now that lily been rubbing on me, girl, don't you rub it no more. Girl, I want you to know. Says, sweetie pie, I want you to know. Well, that lily been loving on me, girl, don't you love it no more. So I'm going back east for a change. Well, all you mamas driving me right out of my brain, saying, baby, saying, honey, I want you to understand. Baby, try and understand. I don't mean you no more good. You better get yourself another man. Well, thank you. I guess I gotta try a harmonica number for you. I didn't have one on my set list, but I've had a few people already mention that, so let's do one for you. Which artichoke music I see has plenty of harmonicas on the shelves. Yeah, the store here is open too if anybody needs to buy anything. They are open. A lot of nice guitars in there too. And other stuff, accordions. Polly put your kettle on, I'll have tea. Bread and butter, good enough for anybody. Bread and butter, good enough for me. Hey now, baby, what do you think? Let me go out and get another drink. Polly put your kettle on, kettle on, kettle on. Polly put your kettle on, we'll all have tea. Bread and butter, good enough for anybody. Bread and butter, good enough for me. Thank you. Hey now, baby, you're on my mind. You got me thinking about it all the time. Polly put your kettle on, kettle on, kettle on. Polly put your kettle on, we're all FT. Bread and butter, good enough for anybody. Bread and butter, good enough for me. New to my repertoire anyway. Yeah, none of these songs I do is new, but this one's actually a little newer than most of the ones I do. This is from 1948 recording by Muddy Waters. And it's pretty deep in the blues. It's about called Train Fare Home. Somebody who's trying to get into a dice game to win is, that's the only way he's going to get home in the near future, is if he manages to win some money gambling. So, keep on worrying me. Blues and trouble. To get lucky and win my train fare home. If I should happen to get lucky and win my train fare home, I'll go back down to Clarksdale. Little girl, that's where I belong. Oh, let's go back down there, Bill. Sad. I wonder this, how can it be? It seems so sad. Little girl, I wonder this, how can it be? Seems like everybody is welcome in this whole world but me. Thank you. Try something by Mississippi John Hurt. Yeah, so John Hurt recorded in the 20s and then had a late life career in the 60s. And they didn't quite know how to present him. He was sort of a folk act in the 60s, although I would say he's definitely a blues act, but his music was like more accessible to the folkies of the 60s than some of the deeper blues artists. So John Hurt also was a very open kind of personality, a very warm-hearted guy who was always willing to teach people and everything, and probably would have fit right in here with us here at Artichoke. Anyway, let me try one of his numbers for you. This is Avalon Blues. This is one he wrote apparently on his way to New York to record in 1929, either on the train or after he got there, and he had the nerve to record it right there while he was there. This is the one that helped people figure out where he lived 40 years later when they found him still living in Avalon, Mississippi. So some people say, yeah, that this was a song he wrote about how much he missed his little town when he went away to New York. It's actually more about how the women in his town missed him when he went away to New York. Avalon's my hometown, always on my mind. Avalon's my hometown, always on my mind. A pretty mamas in Avalon want me there all the time. When the train left Avalon, they were blowing kisses and waving at me. When the train left Avalon, they were blowing kisses and waving at me, crying, come back, daddy, stay right here with me. Put into New York this morning, about 9:30. Put into New York City, 9:30. Got to thinking about Avalon, I couldn't hardly keep from crying. New York's a good town, but it's not for mine. New York's a good town, but it's not for mine. Pretty mamas in Avalon want me there all the time. Avalon's a small town, it's got no great big range. Avalon's a small town, it's got no great big range. A pretty mamas in Avalon sure will spend your change. Thank you. Thank you. I guess I got to do a song or two a piece or two. Actually, these are instrumentals by a man named Richard Saslow, who was you've probably never heard of. He's a reclusive musician. He wrote a book, though, in the 1970s, the late 70s, called The Art of Ragtime Guitar that was a huge influence on me. I borrowed it from the Rochester Public Library and kept it for many, many years. I finally did return it. I mailed it back to them and held my breath. They were going to send me a bill or at least a thank you, but they didn't send me either one of those. But anyway, I did return the book. But I just picked it up because it looked cool. It had to do with guitars and stuff. It wasn't something that I thought I wanted to learn ragtime in it, but it had the sheet music and tablature and photos of hand positions and verbal descriptions of key moments in the pieces, and also had one of those thin records, like that only had grooves on one side. That's what they used to put in instructional books at that time, that you could play it on a record player, but it was like a real flimsy kind of vinyl. And I even preserved that, and when I returned the book, they got that back with it too. But anyway, so it had all these multiple ways to learn, and I worked my way through the pieces in that book, and I didn't stay with ragtime. I mean, I didn't go on to learn more ragtime pieces or anything, but after that like opened up the world of country blues, of the kind of blues that I play now that I had been listening to and just was like, what the heck is that? Two people or three people or wait a minute, no. Okay, that's one person, and he's doing the bass with his thumb and doing something else with his other finger. I remember when I realized that what it was, but I had no idea how to do it. But I mean, I had just played, like, I was playing more electric blues and rock and roll and stuff at the time. But after working my way through this book, it was like, so now I see how you do it. Yeah, you do this with your thumb and this with your other finger. So it really opened up the world and changed my musical life and my life in general. And then a couple of years ago, Richard Saslow comes out with another book, 40 years after the first one. He comes out with his second book and called The Intentional Guitarist. So I was, wow, this guy's still alive and well. I had assumed when I was young that he was a way older man that had done this, but evidently he wasn't. He was only, so I was like 19 when I got the book. He was probably in his mid-20s or something. And this time, instead of the floppy record, it has videos online of him playing the pieces. So I saw, wow, he's still there, he's playing and everything. So I started communicating with him, emailing him and telling him how much I liked his work and asking him some questions about it and stuff. And ended up inviting him to come and do a workshop and concert right here at Artichoke, where we were going to have a lesson on his music, and he and I were going to do a show together. And he was seemed all excited about it and everything. So then Richard got sick, and this was before COVID. He got pneumonia, I probably can't come to the show, but it was a funny thing about him that it was like that was the end of the whole project. You know, like normally if you were gonna come to another city and do a workshop and concert, it'd be like, oh, I'm sorry, I'm sick, can we reschedule this for a couple months from now or next year or whatever, but I think that Richard Saslow did not really want to come to Portland to this show. I think he's been a recluse all of his life. He's a brilliant guitarist and writer for the guitar, but I think he's hardly performed or taught. And I think as it got closer to the show, I had some other clues that he was getting nervous about it. And I think then he got sick, maybe he didn't really get sick. Let's say I'll believe that he got sick, but I think he was relieved. He was relieved that he did, like that was the end of it. So I've tried talking to him since and even offered to go down to his part of the country. He lives in Northern California. I said, maybe we could do it in there. And he says, oh, yeah, that's a great idea. But, of course, he's never followed up on that or anything either. So, anyway, it's kind of, oh, we did have the show. Actually, I taught the workshop and did the show without him. Anyway, it was okay. So it's kind of sad and ironic for me that most of my musical heroes are long dead, of course, and the one who's alive I'll probably never get to meet either, I guess. No, but anyway, whatever. So anyway, let me try a piece or two of his for you. Thank you. Let me get you another one of those quick here. Thank you. All right, two songs from The Art of Ragtime Guitar by Richard Sazlow. Thanks. So while I'm retuning for this last song, I think I got time for one more. Put in a plug for, if you want to learn how to do this stuff, yeah, I teach here at Artichoke, or through Artichoke. Yeah, lately, of course, we've been doing a lot of them online, and I've started doing lessons out in the park lately, but you can still register for them through Artichoke or talk to me after the show. And if you want to hear me play again, I used to play at a lot of places around town. That's kind of slowed down these days, but I am playing a week from tonight at the Cathedral Park Jazz Festival, which I'm very excited about. And that will be out in the park, in Cathedral Park, which is a beautiful park underneath the St. John's Bridge. It's the longest-running jazz festival west of the Mississippi. Last year it was virtual, and when they booked us acts this year. They weren't sure if it was going to be virtual or back in the park, but it is going to be in the park. Thanks. And it's free. It's all weekend. So Friday is blues night. I'm going to be there at 4:30 on Friday. And then there's other blues acts. And then Saturday and Sunday is jazz all day. So come on by to that if you want. Let's see, what else am I up to? I've been playing about once a month at the Flying Fish restaurant on East Burnside. Kind of irregularly, I don't know. Call them and ask them when I'm going to be there again. That's good. But okay. Let's do one by Ma Rainey. Fetch It, which is on one of my CDs. Yeah, I have a couple CDs and a book available for sale out in the behind that curtain there if you want to check that stuff out on your way out.
Thank you.
watch it now. Thank you all very much.
Oh, Steve, I really like that Richard Saslow story. You know, we, in preparation for Richard Saslow, we stocked both books. We still have a few left, and we were actually selling them. So there's a few more Steve Cheseboroughs out there in Portland, Oregon, doubling down on their guitar skills. I want to thank Steve. He's a wonderful teacher. This is wonderful guitar work, and thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, we have a short break right now. I do want to say that we do have two restrooms here on this level. One is right here next to the stage, and the other one is in the back of the store. So as you go through the barn door to the left there, and you just take another quick left, and you just go back to the back of the store where all the ukuleles are. So there you go. And if anybody's interested in ukulele, I can be right there to help you on that. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much. And we'll take a short break, and we'll be right back. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back. The Artichoke Music. First of all, I'd like to welcome our team and let you give them some great appreciation for the people that are supporting you here tonight. First of all, I'd like to introduce our bartender, Allison Ross. She's doing a fine job back there. You are noticing that we've experimented with a few things. We have a menu slightly different, and we are offering a specialty cocktail, so we've added that to our offerings. Also, on our production crew, I'll first introduce Gary Furlow, our director. And Sarah Wolf is our production manager. We also have two interns that are working with us. We have Audrey Price, who's been on sound. And we also have Beckett Martin, who's a student in Seattle. He's here from Cornish School of Arts. Before I start, COVID has been hard on all of us. And it's time to take a little bit of memory of kind of what we've all been through, and to help us do that, Ann Weiss is one of our teachers and a great performer here in town and a deep, dear member of our community, has offered a poem for tonight that I'd like to read to you. It's called Luminaries. When I lay down at night, I think of all the people I love in this city. I see them like the lights you see when your plane is descending. And you think you might die, but the lights get closer. And soon you are safe among them as the starboard wing passes over North Portland. I think of Janice, Lucent with enthusiasm, and Spank, a drummer, of course, music pulsating in his veins. And John, with his bad puns and big heart. Hune, with his quiet power. And Gypsy, who recommends being yourself exactly. And then the plane tilts, and I see the whole gospel choir. Nebula fast appearing as the night goes darker. And now I see the funk band that backs them, and the organ symphony, the tiny trombone players, the timpani player with the gold tooth. And I suddenly think how I might feel if I knew even more, if I knew the stories of my neighbors, gardens they have tended, losses like the eclipse of the sun, hearts broken like secret lovers, perhaps a funny story, like when they joined a naked bike ride, and with the headlamps and flashers on, bumped into their boss. How, if I knew their tribulations and happiness, their fallibility and grit, I might love them too. And if them, then also the neighbors' neighbors. And now all the lights go on. In this big city, from below and above, as the runway clears. And now there are fireflies lighting the way for the homeless. Sarah, who lives under the yellow awning near the gas station. Angel, who is cooking late dinner on a fire under the Burnside Bridge. And the river is a molten gold threading through all of these. Broken and mended, these hearts and bones full of water and light. I think of Nancy, her chutzpah, and heartaches, and of Brenda's silvery laugh, and Finita and Neil up the hill, and Alejandro, who is both a spy and Spider-Man, and all the language being spoken, and all my students and all my teachers, which is to say, everyone. And the night is now so luminous, there is no way to sleep. It's like Yankee Stadium, but with all the fans entranced in the newly opened bleachers, while you, my little love, are shining so brightly from your bed that I must put on sunglasses to even think of landing. Thank you, Ann Weiss, for being here in spirit. Well, it is my honor to introduce to you a great Nashville, crazy good guitarist. I met Porter through Next Door. We did. Porter put out an announcement that he's in Portland, Oregon, and he's looking for places to play and to get to know music and artists in this town. And I said, well, Artichoke Music is the place you need to come. And so I welcome Porter McClister to Portland, Oregon.
Thank you. Trick 1, 2. Let's see if we can get this microphone working. It sounds great in my ear monitor, so make sure these monitors are off. Everything's cool.
Like you've never made a mistake.
Check 1. Oh, man. Check 1, 2. Check 1, 2. Check 1, 2. Is that loud enough? Check 1, 2. Nailed it. All right, y'all. I'm Porter McClister, Nashville guitarist. Thank you so much. I appreciate Bob Howard for having me here tonight at Artichoke to perform my amazingly amazing one-man show that I worked up during the pandemic. Well, first, let's hear it for Gary and Steve that put on a great two performers. That was some fantastic singer-songwriting and an absolute clinic on ragtime guitar, and very nicely done. All right, well, here's a good old cocaine song by Bob Dylan called The Mighty Quinn.
Some are building monuments, and others just attacking down an old. Everyone is underneath, feeding pigeons on a limb. But when Quinn the Eskimo gets here,
so baby, can I tell you who to call? It can't nobody get no sleep, always someone on everyone's toes. But when Clint the Eskimo gets here, everybody's gonna want a dose. All right, come on without, come on.
All right, y'all, here's some country music, the adult country music. This is not like anything you've heard recently on the radio. There's no boat, no pontoon boat, no car, no drinking on a plane. This song is about what could happen if you marry the wrong person. Don't panic. I know that nobody that can hear my voice right now would ever make that kind of mistake, but we all know about 9 people that will do it tonight if they can't. These old country songs are written by professional songwriters, some of them, and they can teach you how to live. This is one of my favorites called The Streets of Baltimore. Well, I sold the farm to take my wall, where she longed to be mistake number one. Left our kin and all our friends in Nashville, Tennessee. Bought those one-way tickets she had often begged me for, and they took us to the streets of Baltimore. Well, her heart was filled with gladness when she saw those city lights, and she said the prettiest place on earth is Baltimore at night. Now a man feels proud to give his woman what she's longing for, and I kinda like the streets of Baltimore. I got myself a factory job and ran an old machine. Bought a little cottage in a neighborhood serene. But every night when I'd get home with every muscle sore, she would drag me through the streets of Baltimore. That's right, girls, you're the bad guy. Well, I did the best that I could to bring her back, back to the country girl she used to be. But soon I realized she loved those bright lights more than me. Now I'm going home on that same train that brought me here before. While my baby walks the streets of Baltimore. You get it now? While my baby walks the streets of Baltimore. Now that's country. Keeping it country for a minute. Now you were mine for just a while, but now you're putting on the style, and you never once look but to your home across the track. Now you're the gossip of the town, but my heart still can be found where you tossed it on the ground. Pick me up on your way down. Pick me up on your way down. When you're blue and all alone, when the glamour starts to pour, come on back where you belong. You might be there to fight and joy, but when they find another love and they take away your crown, pick me up on your way down. When you're blue and all alone, when their clamor starts to bore you, come on back where you belong. You might beat their pride and joy, but when they find another toy and they take away your crown, pick me up on your way down. Thank you. I'm going to pull out all the Nashville tricks on this one here. It's called Wine Drinker Me. If I put it on Wine Drinker Me.
By the way,
you know what? I'm going to skip over to a song here. All right, I found it. So just so you know what's going on here, I'm what kids would call a loop artist, where everything you hear coming out of these speakers, I recorded myself at home on my Fender jazz bass and an Elesis drum set and whatever. So there's no computers involved. Nothing. I've got this pre-recorded, and it's all following me. So, that was good. The one good thing out of the pandemic. Here, it's called Wine Drinker Me.
Well, I'm praying for the rain in California. To me.
Tonight, this is a song that I put together last year for the election, but I continue to do it because Donald Trump continues to try to destroy America every second of the day. This is called Donald Trump, We Hate You. Donald Trump, we hate every inch of you. You've been a snake since 1972. You're the biggest threat the country has ever known. On Air Force One, I wish you'd never flown. Donald Trump, you're a liar and a thief. Not smart enough to read Daily Brief. You're dumber than the dumbest in the land. And you're weaker than the weakest little man. Donald Trump, may you rot and burn in hell. May your walls fall and may we live to tell. And may all the world forget you ever stood. While all your friends confess you did no good. Donald Trump, we hate every inch of you. One more time. One more time. One more time, Donald Trump, we hate you. Donald Trump, we hate every inch of you. You've been a snake since 1972. You're the biggest threat the country has ever known. On Air Force One, I wish you'd never flown. Donald Trump, you're a liar and a thief. Not smart enough to read a daily brief. You're dumber than the dumbest in the land. And you're weaker than the weakest little man. Donald Trump, may you rot and burn in hell. May your walls fall and may we live to tell. And may all the world forget you ever stood, while all your friends confess you did no good. Donald Trump, we hate every inch of you. Thank you so much. I'm Porter McClister, and you've just witnessed the amazingly amazing one-man show. I really appreciate y'all. It's an honor to play for anybody. It's just been such an honor to play inside. I haven't done a gig since August 1st, and this has really been a treat for me. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you, Porter. This is a premiere of his live one-man show indoors. Ladies and gentlemen, I also want you to know that Porter is a Grammy Award winner for his part in the vocals for Oh Brother, Where Art Thou? Yeah, so great to have you here. Great to have you here. Thank you so much, Porter.
Thank you.
Thanks for embarrassing me earlier.
Okay. No worries. Ladies and gentlemen, what a show tonight, huh? This has been wonderful. I'm especially appreciative to everybody out there that's watching. I did hear from Ann Weiss. She was, well, that was just wonderful. Thank you. Let's give Ann Weiss a big hand for her poem tonight. All that couldn't be here. Yeah. Let's give another hand to Tom Arnold, who is out there watching, hoping, wishing that he could be here. Coming up this month, we also have Terry Robb, wonderful fingerstyle, multi-genre guitarist here in Portland, is going to play on the 17th. One of our also favorites, Adlai Alexander, is going to be on stage on Sunday, July 18th, with John Stoll, both wonderful guitarists together. And we have the Sonny Hess Trio that's coming up on the 28th of July. That's a Wednesday night, if I've got that right. And we are working on filling out our Friday Night Coffeehouse calendar coming up. We don't have one that's planned for next week. It's just been a matter of catching up with the fact that COVID has been a little bit up and down. But that's the wonderful part. We also have, what else? At the end of the summer, from on August 26th and through the 29th, we have a wonderful festival that is planned. We're finalizing the lineup, but basically we're going to be here for 3 days celebrating our revival and our return. We have artists Mary Flower, Arietta Ward, Tom May. We've also got a wonderful band that's Dark Swoon, which is an indie alt band. We have, now I'm on the spot. So I also have Pete Katsounis is going to be here for several of those days. So we have a lot of activities planned there. One of our goals is to We're actually hoping that by the money we raise and some of the volunteers that are working for that will be working at that time, we're gonna put beer on tap here at Artichoke, so we can feature some of our local brewers more prominently, so that's one of our goals for that event, among other things, besides having a great time, and that's. Yeah, no, that's good. So let's have another hand for our crew. Gary, who's doing the stage hands. Sarah, Audrey, Beckett, and Allison. Okay. Yeah. No, that's, well, that, I don't think so, Amma. It'll be fine. Yeah. Well, I think you'd still be Amma.
Hello.
As near as I can tell. So.
Hi.
No. Let's give another hand to Porter McClister. What for a great set. Yeah. Well. That was, well, I guess we all have some of those moments there. Meander was supposed to be playing just the week that, for a Friday Night Coffeehouse, the week we closed last year. And so when I started posting that we're posting shows, it was great to have Amma reach out to me to remind me of, you know, that they would still love to do this, and I was honored to have that opportunity. The band, Meander, a duo, is sometimes described as alt-indie, sometimes described as a little bluegrassy, sometimes described as a little grunge, but there's all of those things that are part of that, but there is a little lumineration in their words, I like to say, after the Lumineers. There's a lot of good music here, and I'm honored to present Amma, oh gosh.
And Aaron.
She'll be right, I got it. Amma Bentley and Aaron Moreland. All right. Amma Bentley and Aaron Moreland, thank you so much. Let's give them a big warm welcome.
Thank you all for staying up past my bedtime. I think we're just going to dive in. We'll probably talk some more and stuff, but here's a love song.
You say we have to walk on different roads. You say the words and the sun explodes. You say the words and the sky goes black. 'Cause we both know
never coming back. Be all right. Everything's gonna be all right.
Thank you. So, a couple things. That song's called Silver Lining. I recently entered it in a song contest, the theme of which was Silver Linings. Not only did we not win, we did not place in. So, I hope you enjoyed it. They did not. And second, I want to just tag on to what Bob said. This is our first performance, the first full set since the pandemic. The first show that we had that was canceled due to the pandemic was the one where we were meant to be here on 3/20/2020, which I just was so excited to be here on 3/20/2020. But we're here instead on this day that doesn't have a fun number. I think it's, what, 7/9? Yes. 3/20/2020 is just so much cooler, but this is super, super cool, too.
This'll do.
What's next?
I just have a request for Gary or whoever is up there. Mm-hmm. If I could just hear this instrument a little bit more here, that would be great. Thank you.
That's important to me, too. The last time we played was an open mic a week ago, and I said something that I should say every time we play. I wrote these songs, and Aaron makes them sound better. So here's a funny thing. I don't think we've ever been connected with grunge before, but turns out I actually play a lot of bar chords with just downstrokes. And I know Pride Month is over, but I think I have to come out as a grunge guitarist.
Mind starts to wander, and it wanders even farther. Soon you're dreaming, but you don't know you're asleep. Your life starts to wander, always stranger, always darker. Soon you're dreaming, buried oh so deep. And you spend your waking moments searching for some meaning, and you think that you control it, but you'll never wake from dreaming.
Starts to wander, and it wanders even farther. Soon you're dreaming, but you don't know you're asleep. Your life starts to wander, always stranger, always darker. Soon you're dreaming, buried oh so. You spend your waking moments searching for some meaning, and you think that you control it, but
but you'll never wake from dreaming.
Thanks. Okay, that was called The Second Law of Thermodynamics, and the title's almost longer than the song. This song I didn't write, so do you all know who Dave Carter is?
Yeah.
Okay, well then you may well know this song, because it's a great song by Dave Carter and Tracy Grammer. And it's called Tanglewood Tree. So if you know it, sing along. Love is a tanglewood tree in a bower of green. Fair while the mockingbird sings, but she soon lifts her wings and the music is gone. Young lovers in the tall grass with their hearts open wide when the red summer poppies bloom. Love is a trackless domain. And the rumor of rain in the late afternoon. Love is an old root that creeps through the meadows of sleep when the long shadows cast. Thin as a vagrant young vine, it encircles and twines. It holds the heart fast. Catches dreamers in the wildwood with the stars in their eyes and the moon in their tousled hair. Love is a light in the sky and an unspoken light. I'm walking down a bone dry river, but the cool mirage runs true. I'm banking on the fables of the far, far better things we do. I'm living for the day of reckoning, counting down the hours. I yearn away, I burn away, I turn away the fairest flower love. 'Cause darling love is a garden of thorns,
black crow and a crow in the corn, brick nettles so pretty and wild, and thistles around the edge of the thin dark hours.
When the summer is spent,
lamenting the jaded hearts of men, who nurtures the faith of a child when nothing remains to cover her eyes.
My body has a number, my face has a name.
Each hour like each hour before.
This longing is a voice on the wind.
She cultivates the wages of sin
in the tanglewood tree.
Thank you. Gone far too soon. Coming right up on the anniversary of Dave's untimely passing. It's the 19th. So, for Dave.
What's next? The ocean.
Okay, so, if you're all still awake, or at least as awake as we are, this will be the debut of this song, so I... So, you know, be nice. If we
I was trying to think of what to say. You did it perfectly.
Yeah.
Thumbs it up.
This is kind of, I usually just write songs when, you know, ideas come to me, but a dear friend asked us to perform at his art gallery opening, and the theme of the art show was, now I can't think of what it was. Oh my God, this is a great story, isn't it? Doesn't matter. I wrote this for his art show. It's called The Ocean Is Everything. So the theme was identity, and I write so little about exactly myself that I can't even remember the word identity. So, yeah, a little more personal than some songs, I guess. This next song is also, it's kind of like the opposite of a love song. It's someone had a song about unrequited love. This is about like a relationship that started off and then became kind of very one-sided. And I've told you more than you really need to know. Once upon a time when Aaron and I have been playing music together off and on for 20 years, but there was a time in which we weren't playing, and I had an ad on Craigslist, and I found some people that, you know, wanted to maybe play, and I played this song for them, and their only response was, "Wow, that was dark." And it is.
Get ready.
Tracking the horizon, seeking impossible dawn. A mirage, or is it a vision you try to grasp before it's gone? In this place of shifting shadow, what can you believe? Out of the land of ever autumn, will you rejoice or will you grieve? I will never be the one, never in your sky.
Thanks so much. You know, I really am actually a pretty happy person. So do we have time for one more? I know we've gone over time. Okay. All right. Everyone's still awake out there. It's hard to see. All right. You can hear me not snoring. It's verifiable. So we saved like our longest song for last. So you're welcome. In a longer format show, Aaron and I both play several instruments. We decided to keep it simple and just bring these pretty sunbursty things. But if you want to see us some other time, we have an email list. We have a Facebook thingy. And you can keep up with us that way and maybe see us when we have time to bring all our other stringed things. Oh, and one thing without strings, Aaron also plays the melodica. Right. Okay. If we had a prog rock song, this would be it. But we kind of don't.
This summer has ended, a fading flame, shimmering bits of a dream, through darkness descending. On the darkest day, no beacon shines to guide. Disappears.
This is where we lose our way. And the questions of the seeker, and the answers are like flowers hiding from the day. Darkest day, no beacon shines to guide. Can I find my way if there's no other side? Can my darkest day, no beacon shines to guide. Can I find my no other
so much. Thank you. Thanks so much for being here tonight, and thanks to Artichoke for having us, and thanks for the other three acts for splendid music.
Mm-hmm. Thank you. Thank you, Aaron Moreland. Thank you, Amma Bentley. Thank you all for coming tonight. It's been a pleasure to have you here. See you again soon.